Hello everyone, this is a free online tutorial for the math section of the new SAT exam. This is practice test number 5, problem number 9, section 3, no calculator. Okay, so this is a system of non-linear equations, and how do we know that? Because y is equal to x squared here. Okay, so there's a power of 2 for the x. So in other words, this is a quadratic equation on the top, a parabola, and this is a linear equation because the power of x is 1 here. Okay, so it says if x comma y is a solution of the system of equations above and x is greater than 0, what is the value of x times y? Okay, so let's see. First of all, we find the value of for the y. So what we do is we essentially substitute this y for the x squared that the y represents. You see y is equal to x squared, so we can substitute this value for the y here. So we're going to have 2 times x squared here instead of 2y. So we have 2 times x squared plus 6 is equal to, and then we distribute this part, 2 times x plus 3, right? So this is this is done using distributive property. So we're going to get 2x plus 6 because you're going to distribute the 2 to the x and the positive 3. So you're going to have 2 times x plus 2 times 3. So 2x plus 6. So now you have your equation. So now you're dealing with one equation because you use this first equation to substitute your y. So now you're dealing with one equation only. So now, the easiest part to see is that you have 6 on both sides, so they cancel out, both 6's here, because they're on both sides of the equation. And you're going to carry this 2x on the left side by subtracting 2x from the right side. Right? So you're going to have 2x squared minus 2x is equal to 0. And 0 on the right side, because you got rid of the 2x, you brought it over to the left side by negating it, and the 6's were gone. So you have 0 on the right side. Now, it remains to simply factor. Okay, so 2x squared minus 2x, the left side factors as 2x times x minus 1. And how do I know that? I know that the common factor is going to be 2 times x. Okay, for the x and for the 2x squared and then minus 2x have a common factor of 2 times x. Okay, so you bring this common factor outside of the parentheses. And you're going to deal with simpler terms, x and then negative 1. Okay? So now that you found your factor form, you have two factors, 2 times x and then x minus 1. So these are two separate factors. And they both, when multiplied, when they're both multiplied, they're equal to 0. So that means that 2x is equal to 0 or x minus 1 is equal to 0. Because both of them are factors, so each of them may be equal to 0. So when 2x is equal to 0, x will be equal to 0 as well, because 2x divided by 2 is going to be 0 by 2, which is 0. So x will be equal to 0. Now, when x minus 1 is equal to 0, you bring the 1 to the right side by adding 1 on both sides, and you're going to have x is equal to 1. Okay? Now, I use bold here, bold color, to show you that we need to use this x in order to find the product of x times y. Why? Because it says that x is greater than 0, right? So we have to have a positive value of x to find the value of the product xy. Okay, so we use this positive value, and we know that y is equal to x squared, right? So x squared will be 1 squared. So y is equal to 1, because 1 squared is also 1. Okay, so y is equal to 1 and x is equal to 1. So xy, the product, will be 1 times 1. And that's simply 1. So the correct answer is A in this problem.